Coming up on BYU Basketball with Dave Rose, it's Coach Rose's birthday, and his guys gave him an early gift over the weekend, a big win against Utah. The coach is here to break that down. Plus, our guest in studio is Yoli Childs. He joins us here in Studio C, where BYU Basketball with Dave Rose starts now.
For us to be able to really kind of dominate the score, I think that says a lot about our guys and our determination.
Celius, left corner, Eli again. Again for three! Elijah Bryant! Bryant, left wing, Dastrup again. Again! Nick Dastrup!
This is BYU Basketball with Dave Rose, presented by Siegfried & Jensen, live from Studio C in Provo, Utah, with your host, the voice of the Cougars, Greg Wrubell.
Hello, once again, Cougar Nation. Welcome inside the beautiful BYU Broadcasting Building in Provo, Utah, for our weekly get-together with the head coach of the Cougars and BYU basketball fans. Good crowd on hand here tonight here in Studio C. We are live here every Tuesday, and we invite you to be a part of our audience by requesting your free seats at byucougars.com/Roseshow. We'd love you to join the conversation on Twitter using hashtag RoseShow. If you've got questions for Coach Rose or Yoli Childs, send them on in. Joining me on our on-court set is the head coach of the Cougars, Dave Rose. And first things first, happy 60th birthday to Coach Rose.
Thank you. You know, I've always thought that people who have a December birthday get the shaft, you know, all the time, because your birthday presents are always wrapped in Christmas, you know, paper, and everybody's trying to figure out what they're going to get, and so they just kind of give you something to get to Christmas. But I think the real issue for me and a December birthday is that it's always right during the basketball season. And how many shows have we done, Greg, over the years where it was my birthday?
Either on or right around, quite a few.
Yeah, quite a few. Yeah. And you seem to make a really big deal out of it. And I actually really appreciate that. I think that the more attention you can draw to me on
my
birthday.
That's what you're all about, yeah. Well, we appreciate you indulging us, but it is a big one. It's a big number. It's a round number.
One time I didn't know if we'd actually make it to here. So I'm excited that we're here, and I'm excited that tomorrow it won't be my birthday and we can get ready for Idaho State.
But it's been a good day so far.
Yeah, it has. It's been great. My grandkids, they make a big deal. There's a lot of balloons around here. I've never actually seen a balloon shaped in the number of a six.
We've got a six and a zero up there. Big old blue. There we go. Yeah.
Maybe someday we can actually turn that upside down.
Just 30 years from now, we'll do the show on your 90th, and we'll be off and running. I mentioned the early birthday present, and it really kind of was that on Saturday night. Your guys played a great game and got the weekend off to a wonderful start. It was a great night of college basketball. The environment, the crowd, the way your guys played, just a perfect night.
Yeah, it was great. The students were terrific. It actually, you know, the Merritt Center, when it's, you know, when you're practicing in there every day, it seems like it's huge. But when it is packed and full, it seems like a really small arena. But usually there's only one event that's actually going on, and that's the game. In this game, there's a couple events going on. The students were extremely prepared for a long wait, you know, for that home game to finally be returned. And so it didn't stop. It was pretty you know, pretty emotional, pretty electric the entire night.
When people talk about missing the rivalry, that's what they missed, was those kinds of environments, right?
Yeah, and I think that, you know, the best thing about, you know, these rivalries now is, you know, you play once a year and then you don't worry about it for another year. But the fact that this one got interrupted, I think, made this actual night probably a little bit more intense, you know, if you want to say that. But our guys were ready for it. We played really well. I thought Utah played well. The numbers, when you look at the stat line, it's pretty similar all across the board, you know, except for the three-point line. That's where, you know, it was a big difference for us, and I think that's probably where the game was won. But I'm really happy for our players, because to be able to beat all the teams in the state, you know, and of course we didn't play Southern Utah, so, you know, we didn't beat them. But I think we'll kind of just, that game was in the works, and then they decided not to play it. So And they're, you know, they've got a nice season going on right now. But we had a nice run with the four teams that we did play. So excited for that.
In this game, made a big three when it got to five. Peyton Dastrup makes a big three when it got to five, and a second one later. We'll talk about Peyton in a bit. But every time Utah had a little run going, you guys answered.
Yeah, I thought we really were really patient. We executed well for most of the night, but especially in really challenging situations. I thought defensively we were pretty solid. It was a challenge with those big guys inside, but I thought we did a good job of covering down, getting our guards involved. They turned it over a few times, and then they weren't so confident with the ball, and they got it out quicker. And then we got to their shooters. They drove us a few times and got to the rim, but for the most part, I thought that defensively we executed our game plan for the majority of the night.
Now, it was the first win against Utah in 5 years, but there was a year skipped in there, as we know. But before that, you'd won seven in a row. So this thing, if you look back the last 12 meetings, BYU has won eight of these games. And this thing does tend to sometimes have its dips and cycles.
Yeah, and since we did win, we probably ought to say that Utah hasn't beat us in 2 years, you know, because...
That's true. Not since 2015, yeah, yeah. Elijah Bryant in this game has arguably his best game as a Cougar. He scored more in a game, but I think considering the stakes, everything was on the line. He goes 29 points, 9 rebounds, 4 assists, 3 blocks, and a steal. Becomes the WCC Player of the Week as a result. First one for BYU. He was tremendous.
You know, in big games, all throughout our career here at BYU, is that all you really need is one guy. I mean, our guys, we got really good players, and you get one guy to kind of lead out, and the rest of the guys will all follow. I think this group, especially defensively, is really locked in. And on the offensive end, you know, we have good execution. We have so many options. The week before, I thought TJ was that guy that was kind of leading out, and we're all following him. Yoles had a tremendous three-week period, you know, where he was just, you know, kind of that leader. So I look forward to, you know, adding to this group, to add Peyton Dastrup. He's had a couple big games in the last five games that can really maybe put his confidence over the mark. Jashir and McKay, and once we get Dahl back, I like the makeup of the group, and I think that, as our guys have said in all kinds of different interviews, that whatever they're going to try to take away, you know, then we're going to, you know, we'll try to go somewhere else and do it. And I think that it involves not only just our execution on the floor, but actually the personnel that we do it with. So hopefully that continues.
In the second half, Yoli was a little bit taken away because of health, actually. So Eli's big night was even more handy considering what Yoli was going through that night. He had to kind of gut that thing out to get to the end. And Eli was there to pick Yo and everybody up. But he was having a great night until the leg started to give out a little bit.
He got some cramps. And that, I was, you know, petrified walking out there to see what was going to happen. But when I got out there and Robert, our trainer, said that he's having cramps, that's probably about the best thing that you want to hear, you know. When
it hurts like the heck for him, but yeah, for you.
I talked to him today for a bat. He said, I felt bad because it looked like, you know, my leg was falling off, but and it was just cramps. And I said, it's never just cramps because cramps are really painful. But, you know, Yo got off to such a great start in the game and got us going and I think calmed everybody down. And, you know, they started in that zone, which I think kind of surprised all of us. But they were out on the perimeter, and so Yoli had space in there. And we got the ball to him, and, you know, he converted on two or three baskets early. And it was, you know, a great team effort. And I think Yo picked us up early, and then the guys picked Yo up, you know, late in the game when he, you know, was having some problems with his cramps.
So BYU beats Utah by 12. You mentioned three-point shot as a big factor. And the bench play, which includes that, was pretty decisive, too. You outscored Utah by 14 on the bench in a game you win by 12. Zach makes some big shots. McKay came in, played really well. And then Peyton, as we kind of hit on, at a really key stretch of the game, goes on a little mini run of his own there that kind of helped to push that thing where you could keep it comfortable.
You look at those three guys and what they brought, you know. And Zach Seljaas especially, not just the points and the rebounds, but his ability to space the floor. Peyton does the same thing. When Peyton picks and then when he pops, you know, to the perimeter, you have to go out there and guard him because that's one of the things that he does really well. He's a really good passer. He's a really good shooter. You know, I think he's getting better as a rebounder and a defender. But and then McKay, when McKay comes in, they kind of have a plan for Jashier, and McKay complements Jashier's game so well that they better change really quick, you know. And I think we caught them in a couple of rotations where you know, they weren't really aware of personnel, and we were able to kind of exploit that a little bit. But well, I think we got 7, 7, and 8 from those three guys coming off the bench, but they brought a lot more than just the you know, those points.
All right, segment one is in the books. We're heading into our first break here on the show, and as we do, want you to know that you can enjoy a full hot breakfast buffet, dinner Monday through Wednesday, a kitchen, and a large grassy backyard along the Provo River Trail, all at the Residence Inn Marriott in Provo. When we come back, the Cougars have their longest win streak in almost 3 years. We'll talk about it next on BYU Basketball with Dave Rose here in Studio C.
BYU Food to Go's convenient location at 2191 North Canyon Road in Provo makes bringing popular BYU foods to your next event easy. Everything's ready when you need it at the drive and load pickup. You drive in and they load no matter the weather. And stop in the on-site creamery for great BYU chocolate milk and ice cream. BYU Food to Go, bringing campus to your table. Call for details, 801-422-5001.
Moving your family doesn't have to be stressful, not when you use Bailey's Moving and Storage. For 65 years, we've moved families, companies, and busy individuals like you across town and across the country. From planning to unpacking, families have trusted Bailey's for many years to be their partner every step of the way. Whether it's local, long distance, international, an office move, or more, be sure to begin with Bailey's. The official mover of BYU Athletics, Bailey's Moving and Storage. More than just a move.
Blue runs deep on BYU TV. Don't miss the BYU Montana State women's basketball game live Friday at 4 Eastern, 2 Mountain. Watch all of your favorite BYU teams on BYU TV, your home for Cougar sports.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let our earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing.
BYU Basketball with Dave Rose is presented in part by the BYU Creamery, the classic BYU tradition. Have a scoop today. And by Smith's, low prices, market fresh at Smith's.
All right, back in on BYU Basketball with Dave Rose. After playing 6 of their first 10 games outside of the Marriott Center, BYU opened a 5-game homestand with that win over Utah on the weekend. It improves BYU to 9-2. Best start to a year since the Jimmer Mania season back in 2010-11, Coach. 9-2.
Yeah, these guys have done a tremendous job. I've alluded to a lot of, you know, different personnel issues that we've kind of gone through since before the season started and now, you know, during the season with some injuries. But the guys have just kind of found a way, you know, to win games. And I think that, you know, that really difficult travel stretch where we flew to Princeton, flew home, had a midweek game, then we flew back to Brooklyn. Once we got through that stretch, I really felt like the guys could settle in on. We still had a lot of road games and games outside of our building, but they were in the state, and now we're home for 5 games. We started with a win, and we've got 2 big games this week, and so, you know, hopefully our guys will be ready. There's a lot going on. I mean, last week we had a great week, but, you know, we had the Christmas party for the, you know, the children with cancer, and then this week we have finals, and we have 2 games in this week, so there's a lot of things to worry about, which makes coaching really fun.
The win you had over the weekend gave you 6 straight wins, longest win streak since 2014-15. How much do those things matter to you? The fact that you get on a roll and start racking them up and get to 5-6.
Man, well, I tell you, you don't actually try to plan these things. I mean, you just hope that that's what happens, is that you are good enough to put the last win behind and then tackle the next challenge. And It's hard. It's not easy. You look at Indiana, for example. I mean, Saturday they have one of the biggest wins ever, and they beat Notre Dame, yeah, a nationally ranked team. They go home, and last night they lost an in-state game to Indiana Fort Wayne by 20 on their home floor. So it's a real challenge to keep an edge to you and to treat each game. And really, as this thing works, the more games you win, the more important the next game is. And that's kind of where we are. We put ourselves in a nice spot if we can finish this non-conference schedule out and then we move on to the conference schedule starting next week. The week after next, where we have two home games to start it. So, and in those situations, you realize if you're going to win a league championship, you just, in this league, it's just hard to, can't drop those home games.
So of the six straight wins you've got going, the opponents scored fewer than 70 in all six. The last time you went six straight games under 70 was 9 years ago. Now, tempo's a part of it, right, but not all of it. This team is believing in defending, and it's showing up.
Yeah, and I think that it's a group of guys who have kind of got together and said, hey, listen, this is what, we need to do. This needs to be our personality. This needs to be what we, kind of rely on. One thing we always know is that defense travels, and you can get out in other people's gyms and you can guard them. And you have to be able to adjust to each night as far as the officials and how that's being called. But if you have enough depth and you can overcome it and get through it, I just think the makeup of this team, can be really consistent. And so far we've got off to a nice little start here.
Now, Dave, the numbers and the anecdotal evidence say that you're playing slower, but not just slower, better on offense, better in the half court, efficient, productive. It's a really good offensive team, even with fewer possessions right now.
Yeah, and I think that, the thing is that we've got everyone involved, okay? And it's not just limited to a couple guys, one side, throw it in the post, and then, try to read the post guy. I mean, we've got a lot of things happening, and I think that our guys have really kind of embraced it, their ability to put the ball on the floor, to read the defense, and then be able to react. Big guys rolling to the basket, popping the space. I just believe that it's a group of guys that have got enough patience to read the defense and then be able to kind of respond to it. And right now, we're shooting. I think we played three games in a row. We've shot over 50% from the field. And we get the right guys fouled and get to the free throw line. We're a really good free throw shooting team. And so I've got a lot of confidence in this group, and the most important thing now is to break each game down into an individual challenge. Not get too far ahead of yourself. Not be so happy in what you've done, and just approach each day with a real business-like attitude and move forward. Our guys do a really good job of participating in the scout when we actually put the scout team together. Put the game plan together. There's a lot of teams where you put that up there, and after about 5 minutes, they're sitting there trying to keep their head, from bobbing around.
Yeah.
But this group's got a good concentration level to it, and I look forward to seeing how they respond to this, because this is another challenge for us here.
Yeah, speaking of the concentration, two-game week and a finals week for BYU. On Thursday, Bill Evans brings his team down from Pocatello. Idaho State is in. Now, they've won four in a row after opening 0-5.
And they're really shooting the ball well right now. They kind of are like us. They got a mid-season guy, that was declared eligible, and he's a really good shooter. This team shoots the three really well. They transition really well. They mix up their defense a little bit. So, and then they're physical. They got a 7-footer, and their wings are big. So, I'm really excited to see how our guys can kind of put this win behind them and then, be able to tackle the next chore here we got.
You mentioned Indiana a bit ago. Back in the day, their coach was Mike Davis. Mike Davis is now at Texas Southern. They're your weekend foe coming in on Saturday. They lost at TCU last night, number 15 TCU. Had them tied in the second half. Had a lead in the second half, I think, a short one. Now, the Tigers are 0-12, but it's not a joke to call them the best 0-12 team in the country, because actually the analytics are pretty good on them, and every game's been true away. And toughest schedule in the country right now, number one ranked strength of schedule.
Yeah, they do have the toughest schedule, and I don't think they'll play their first home game until mid-January. So, those kind of teams are always you know, really scary because they're hungry guys. They're looking for that first win. They've got a little point guard. It's going to be really hard for us to stay in front of. But and Mike does a really good job of raising money for his university in November and December. And then he does a great job of winning his league and getting to the NCAA tournament in January and February. So
what they did last year, right? 60-2 in league, got to the dance.
So we'll catch them on their last you know, road game for the preseason, and you know, hopefully when we're in good shape, then we'll have to put this Thursday night game on. And you never, I mean, everybody always kind of predicts what's going to happen, but in reality, you know, you've got to play that game on Thursday and then see what you're left with on Friday morning to attack the Saturday thing. And I think it's a pretty good week for us simply because we have, this is what Christmas week will be like. We'll have, you know, Christmas Eve on Sunday, Christmas on Monday, they'll have off. And that's what we did this week. We gave Monday off and we'll go Tuesday, Wednesday, then play Thursday, Saturday. So hopefully we get in some kind of a rhythm here to get started for next week.
Which will be league play, of course. Tonight's player guest, by the way, is Yoeli Childs. He joins us next. And he kind of embodies what you'd want any, you know, sophomore to look like after a really good freshman season. Get even better, expand his game, do more things. He's been tremendous for you.
Yeah, and he spent so much time at this. This is a real passion for him. He loves the game. He loves to compete. He loves to work out. I mean, he's a guy who kind of plans his life around basketball, which are the kind of guys coaches like, you know. And so it's fun to see him just mature. He's a really good student, a guy who takes his academics serious. And it was funny because he I don't know how much he likes the academics, but he hates to not do well in it, which is actually an unbelievable combination because he complains a little bit about it, but he always does pretty well.
Well, as we mentioned off the top, and Yoeli is coming up next, by the way, it's our birthday edition of the Rose Show this week. The coach celebrating a big day, and celebrating with him are some Cougars, past and present.
Happy birthday, Coach. 60, unbelievable. You're really old. But, man, just like cheese, you know? It gets better with age. Hope you have a great day.
Hey, Coach. Hope things are going well. I wanted to wish you a happy birthday. I hope that you're having a wonderful holiday season with your family, friends, as well as the team.
Hey, Coach Rose. It's Elijah Bryant. I just wanted to say happy 60th birthday, and thank you for allowing me to come to BYU.
Coach Rose, happy birthday. You only get a day over 60. Hope it's a beautiful day for you. Excited to see what the next 60 brings. Take care.
Happy birthday, Coach Rose.
60 big ones, Coach. Congratulations. Known you since way back in, I think, 1989 at Dixie College when I played for you. Still the same guy.
Happy 60th birthday, Dave. Guys are really competing. Hope you have a great day.
Coach Rose, what's up? It's Lamont. Just wishing you a happy birthday. Big 6-0. Enjoy it, young fella.
Happy birthday, Coach Rose. Hope you have a good one, and I've enjoyed my time here, and I'm sure I will for the rest of the years to come. Happy birthday.
What's up, Coach Rose? Just wanted to wish you a happy birthday. Hope you're doing well, and congratulations on a great start to the season. Wish you and the guys the best of luck, and I hope you have a happy birthday.
Hey, Coach Rose. Happy birthday. Big 6-0.
Happy birthday, Coach. Hope it's a great one.
Coach, happy 60th birthday. I'm so proud to be here and be back with you, and I hope you have a great day. Thanks.
Coach, happy birthday. Hope you have a great day. You deserve it. Thanks for all you do for me and for BYU.
Happy birthday, Coach Rose. Hope you have the best birthday ever.
Hey, Coach. Good morning from China. I just wanted to say happy birthday. Have a little bit of a cold, so sorry about that, but I hope you had a great day. It was so great to see you guys play the other night. I was able to watch the Utah game, and you guys played amazing. So I'm sure that's a great birthday present for you, but thanks for everything you've done for me and for my family. I love you, Coach, and hope you guys continue to have a great year. And I want to say, hey, Cheryl. Bye.
This business is about relationships.
Yeah, those are good guys. I wish I had them all on the team this year. We'd be really deep with that group, wouldn't we?
Be pretty good.
Yeah.
You win a few.
Keep bringing them out off the bench. But I've had a wonderful ride here with these guys, and hopefully we just, you know, keep on going. Because I think this team is as good as any group we've had, and hopefully we can keep coming together and building this team.
Absolutely. Well, it was great. Hope you enjoyed that.
Thanks. It was awesome.
Yeah. All right, we're heading to our next break. Utah Community Credit Union, helping people make smart decisions every day. At UCCU, you can get a low fixed rate on a home equity line of credit and lock in that low rate for 10 years with absolutely no closing fee. To learn more, visit UCCU.com. After the break, sophomore big man Yoeli Childe joining us in Studio C. This is BYU Basketball with Dave Rose.
Hi, I'm Dave McCann with BYU TV Sports. Each season, we invite companies like yours to be a part of the BYU brand, aligning your business with respected academics and athletics. Becoming a corporate partner means you'll benefit from showcasing your products and services with game day signage, social media, radio, and TV campaigns. Whether on the field, in the stands, or on the air, BYU's here to help your brand grow. Email sponsorship at byu.edu today.
I believe it's really important to be well-rounded. Being here at BYU is the best decision I ever made.
There's a time for everything. When it's time for basketball, locked in to play hoops.
My first love is basketball. I want to play basketball as long as possible. I love the challenge.
Hey, Sammy, heads up. Come on, it's your turn.
We just lost
48 wishes. Wait, I think I know what you're thinking and I don't think I like it.
Excuse us, are you actual elves? I don't think so, that's impossible.
My first love is basketball. I want to play basketball as long as possible. I love the challenge.
Watch BYU take on Idaho State live this Thursday at 9 Eastern, 7 Mountain. We're all in to BYU TV Sports.
Social media, hashtags, internet, what? These are some super confusing things, but all you need to know is that Studio C is on YouTube and we are always releasing new videos. Subscribe to see all the cool stuff we're going to be doing next.
Find Studio C on YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. Connect with us, we'll connect with you.
You're watching BYU TV. See the good in the world.
Pause, pause to Yo, and Yoeli Childe with a throwdown. Low to Yo, got a good seal, and a dunk. Beautiful. Gesture will float it low to Yo. And it's an alley-oop. Top of the key, Yo for three, and it's good. Yoeli Childe knocks down the three-pointer. Yoeli Childe.
Welcome back to BYU Basketball with Dave Rose, with your host, the voice of the Cougars, Greg Rubel.
All right, so we are back inside Studio C here at BYU TV for our BYU Basketball with Dave Rose. Watch us on BYU TV and hear us on BYU Radio every Tuesday evening. Time to say hello now to tonight's special guest. He is the baby on the BYU basketball team, the youngest player on the roster by age, but he's playing like a savvy veteran, a sophomore out of Bingham High School. Please welcome number 23, Yoeli Childe. Good to see you.
What's going on, Coach? How you doing?
Good to have you with us.
Good to be here.
You're bundled up?
Yes, sir. It's cold out there, man.
That it is. So as great as the win against Utah was on Saturday night, I've had so many fans come to me and just want to know one thing. How's Yoeli doing? It was a rough night for you physically to get through that one. Take us back to that night. What was going on and how you are doing today?
I'm good, first of all. It's not that serious. I just started cramping up, rolled my ankle a little bit, so we're good, though. It's all good.
Kind of thing you could have seen coming in any way, the fact that you get cramps in that game?
No. It's never happened to me before. Super annoying game for it to happen in, but, oh, don't show that. That's embarrassing. Look at me.
There's your trainer, Elijah Bryant, working on you.
I'm just soft. It's fine. But, no, I mean, we got the win. That's all I care about, so it's all good.
Late in the game, you're trying to gut it out again, and it seems like the other one might have locked up on you a little bit, and there it was again, and you got your boys with you. And again, I guess it looked worse than maybe it was. Coach said he was petrified when it first went down, but then when he hears cramps, he thinks it's okay. But at the time, it hurts like the devil, right?
Yeah, it's super painful, but it's a short-term thing, so that's good.
How badly did you want to get back in?
Oh, so bad, man. That's a game I've been looking forward to for so long. So it was rough not being able to be out there at the end, but it was super cool to see guys step up. Awesome to see Peyton come in and play the way he did. So it was just super cool to see my guys take over.
Dave, the thing about Yo is he's a pretty durable guy. He really takes care of his body and does things the right way.
Absolutely, and he's durable, you know, for minutes. He's played a lot of minutes this year, and when you look at Ryan Andrus and Braden Shaw and Dalton Nixon, you know, who are standing there on the sideline, those are all, you know, low post guys who can play minutes, and Yo's kind of just picked everybody up and, you know, ridden through it, and hopefully we get these guys back soon.
Now, Yoli, in an effort to get you back on the floor, trainer Rob Ramos mixed up a secret elixir, a hydration concoction of some kind. How did it taste? How was that?
Disgusting.
Yeah.
I don't know what was in it, but it was just super salty, gross. You don't want to try it.
You don't want to try it? Well, you say I don't want to try it. Well, we found out what's actually in it. This is the drink. It is Powerade mixed with what they call a solstice packet with 25 ingredients, including vitamin C, vitamin E, riboflavin, B6, B12, potassium, fructose, and sea salt, along with other ingredients.
Yeah, there's probably a little bit off that.
And here it is. This is the actual beverage. Rob has mixed some up. You said it's not so great?
No, you gotta chug the whole thing. You gotta drink like three of them. There you go. You can keep an eye on it.
That's because you're afraid your throat might cramp up.
Well, as Ron Burgundy might say, goes down smooth. Yeah. That was something. That's a little salty. You're right about that. The Utah game itself, you got off to a great start, and the team got off to a great start. You guys led for almost the entire way. How big was it just to get off right and play with the lead most of the night?
I mean, that's always huge. It's a lot easier to play ahead than it is to try to come back. But I think that's just a testament to how hard this team's worked and the system that we're running. Before the game, Coach told us that we're built for this. And I think that describes it perfectly. Just the way we run our offense, the way we make the extra pass. We always know that it's going to be someone's night. Like it was Eli's night, he went off, and that's just the way our offense is. Sometimes it's going to be Eli, sometimes it's going to be me, sometimes it's going to be TJ. And just the way we run our offense, the way we trust each other, and the way we play defense together, we're built for big games.
Well, the last few weeks, we've heard Yoli Childs here give a great feedback on his teammates during our weekly video vignettes. Tonight, the tables turn as a Yoli's fellow Cougars have a go at Yo.
Yoli's he's kind of a clown.
There's never a dull moment with Yoli. He's always talking. I don't think I've ever heard him be quiet.
Yoli's a big talker.
He always has something to say that can be good and bad.
If you're in any room and you hear someone talking, it's Yoli.
I think Yoli's a little bit of a goofball in a great way.
He's a really fun guy to be around.
He always brings energy to the room. He's a very happy guy.
He's like Kanye. I think he's like that. He has something to say.
LeBron James and Kanye West. Those are his two people right there. He's always talking about them.
He loves to argue, too. I mean, you get him talking about LeBron James, and you're not going to win no matter what.
If he has an opinion on something, it's more than an opinion. It's essentially a fact.
He'll talk about anything, and he loves sharing his opinions.
And he's always looking to make people laugh.
He likes to be up in front of people. He's not afraid of the audience, so he'd find a way to be a people pleaser for sure.
Maybe a professional like 2K player or something. He's pretty good at 2K. Don't tell him I said that.
People say we're the life of the party, but if it wasn't for Yoli, it probably wouldn't be designated the life of the party.
Yoli is extremely passionate, and it's very contagious.
He makes playing the game so much fun, and being on the court with him is a blast.
He's just a fun guy to be around altogether.
All right, those are your boys. You had your turn with some of them, and what did you think of what they had to say?
I was looking forward to seeing what they were going to say. I want to see if they were going to roast me, but it turned out okay.
And Coach Rose, it seems like when most of the guys are talking about the other guys, it seems like each of them think that the other guy is pretty talkative.
Yeah, and I think, you know, it is quite an interesting group. But what I liked about these guys is they understand that when Yoli talks his opinion, it's a fact. Isn't that right?
Pretty much, yeah.
Pretty much. It's a
pretty well-informed opinion. Yeah. All right, more with Yoli coming up. Fans, whether you're sitting in the stands at the game or wrapped up on the sofa watching from home, Minky Couture is the best blanket ever, the best gift ever. Learn more at softminkyblankets.com. More with Yoli Childs coming up in our next segment. It's some Q&A as well. This is BYU Basketball with Dave Rose. 10 questions is also coming up. Stay with us.
In the timeline of life, you make choices every day, like buying your first car, what a beaut, or serving your mission. You come home and hop right into college, and then that magic day comes, marriage. Getting married is incredible and pricey, but you know what? Children are even pricier. Your family grows, and you need that first home. No matter where you are in the timeline of life, Deseret First Credit Union is right there with you. DFCU, your values, your timeline, your financial future.
Evelyn, there's a new girl.
Your name is Rose. You have nowhere else to go.
Why is Mr. Crampton so unkind?
He may be harsh, but he's fair. You're a mean, lonely old man.
If you keep up this defiance, you'll stay in the attic overnight.
No one's ever stood up to Mr. Crampton before. You were so brave.
It's not too late to make things right.
There's not so much a BYU Sports Nation dance, per se, but Jerem can't stand it when it's really quiet, you know, so he'll turn on some music, and then it's just like, you know, just move the shoulders a little bit.
He gave you a dance move? What in the world are you talking about?
And I'm looking so just not cool right now.
He did that for the cameras. That does not happen. This would be Spencer's. It'd be the stanky leg. Okay. Not mine. Spencer's.
That's what we do. We just want to relax.
BYU Basketball with Dave Rose is presented by Siegfried and Jensen, helping Utah families for over 25 years.
It is our weekly look at Cougars in the pros. Congratulations to Kyle Collinsworth, signs a two-way contract with the Dallas Mavericks. Great news for Kyle, he's worked so hard on his game. Jimmer Fredette drops another 50 in China. He joined us a little while ago from China. Eric Mika playing in Italy, a double-double in a recent game. Charles Abubo, who joined us also, playing in France, and Brandon Davies out there in Lithuania. All right, we are with Yoli Childs back on BYU Basketball with Dave Rose. And I really love your story, how you got to BYU, the whole thing, but especially because so much of your story involves mom and how special she is to you and what's gotten you here to where you are today. What would you like to tell our audience, Cougar Nation, just about how important mom has been in your life?
Man, how much time do we have? I mean... my mom's my hero. She's here today. It's pretty cool to see her. Yeah, I get the camera on her. She's pretty, isn't she? But she's an amazing woman that sacrificed so much for me and my brother, and I wouldn't be half the man I am today, and I wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for her. Just growing up, there's so many paths that my life could have gone down, and the way it's gone is because of her. And the way I work is because of her. She's my motivation on the court. She's my motivation off the court. Through everything in my life, I just try to say if I could be, yeah, those are, oh, cutie. But I try to say if I could be half the person that she is, then that'd be pretty great. So she means the world to me.
Coach Roseanne. Dave, as you began getting involved with Yoli and Netta's mom, did you get a sense pretty quickly of what Yoli's talking about here?
Absolutely. I think that, you know, he was really complimentary of his mom early, but then you could just tell when you had them together, you know, how much love they had for each other and how much they knew about each other and how you know, the conversations that they were having. It wasn't like, you know, a mom and a son. It was kind of like friends, you know. And And Yoli was on my side early because his mom wasn't really sure about BYU, but you know, she was convinced pretty quick when, you know, when Yo said that this is what he wanted to do, she jumped right on board and said, "Okay, I'll support him 100% in it." And so far, it's worked out pretty good, huh?
Yeah.
So you surprised mom, Kara, a little bit when you said you're coming to BYU?
A little bit, yeah. Yeah, I gave her a lot of BYU surprises. Mom, I'm getting baptized. All those kind of things. So I keep her on her toes.
All right. It may not be a surprise for you. I think you know what's coming. But every guest on the Rose Show sits in the hot seat for a few minutes. We call it our 10 questions portion of the program. And it's kind of got a game show vibe to it. But it really doesn't work with the game show vibe unless you get a long, skinny mic. And so we finally created a long, skinny mic for the game show. So here we go. Here's our 10 questions leaderboard right now. Jasheer had a big week last week. He vaulted right to the top. Got 9 out of 10 right. So here we go. 10 questions now for Yoli Childs. Some have correct answers, and some just have answers that whatever you say is going to be the correct answer. So we kind of mix them up.
All right. A lot of those.
All right, question number one. You have 21 of BYU's 22 dunks this season. Who has the other one?
TJ Haas. Yeah!
All right, one for one. You are accurate. Question number two. What does your first name, Yoli, mean?
Well, it's my full name. It means do the will of God.
Okay. Woo-hoo. Question number three. Your single game career high in scoring at BYU is 24 points. Against which team did you score 24?
UVU. These are tough ones, man.
Now, we've not done very well with any of our movie questions so far. Uh-huh. The Hollywood movie questions have not fared well with the guys. This is my bad. But this scary movie from the late 1980s features an evil doll named Chucky that comes to life. What is the name of the movie?
If this is wrong, all right, Chucky? I don't know. See, I hate scary movies, though. That's not fair.
The movie's name is Child's Play. Child's Play. That's why we went with the, yeah, there you go. Okay. But hey, you know, do not despair. 3 out of 4. All right. During both of his stints with the Cavaliers, LeBron James wears jersey number 23. Your number, right? Which number did he wear in his 4 seasons with the Miami Heat?
6. Yeah. That's tough. Okay.
Question number 6. This toy is described as, quote, a thick grooved double disc with a string attached to its center axle that is made to fall and rise to the hand.
A yo-yo.
Yeah.
Clever.
Now you're
clever.
Thinking. Now yeah. You're thinking. Yep. That's a 5 out of 6. Your single game career high in rebounds is 17. Against which team did you pull down 17?
San Francisco.
Yeah, at San Francisco last year. You've only missed 1, 6 out of 7. Question 8.
Gotta tie that boy.
You have 2 teammates who are both listed at 6 foot, 185 pounds. Who are they, both of them?
McKay Gannon. He actually is. Then probably Jasheer, even though he's like 5'8".
Listed at 6 feet, but yes, you got them both. All right. Which of your teammates is the best singer?
None of them. Last year, Davin Gwynn.
Last year, Davin. Okay.
Sing, but
and
no
none of them
this
is the correct
year.
Answer. Way to go. He's 8 of 9. This is to tie Jasheer at 9 of 10.
Pressure's on.
You have to pick one BYU coach to join your 2-man team in a 3-point shooting contest. Which coach are you choosing?
Coach Rose.
There we go. Okay.
Of course.
Yes. That is an excellent 9 of 10. And again, the only question missed is my stupid movie question. I'm going to learn my lesson at some point. But yes, Child's Play was the name of the movie. Way to go. 9 out of 10. Yoli Childs, everybody. There he is, top of the leaderboard. More BYU basketball with Dave Rose coming up next. Stay with us.
Anxiety, restlessness, insomnia, fatigue, depression, weight gain. The biggest thing that patients don't understand about low thyroid is that it's usually not a thyroid problem. It's actually an autoimmune disease that's attacking the thyroid called Hashimoto's disease. For us, it's really cool to see how much of an impact
we can make at Red River for these patients' health and for their quality of life.
Red River Health and Wellness can help with a treatment plan remotely or at any one of our locations.
Hi, I'm Ashley Matthews. I have an interview.
The position's been filled.
I got the perfect job for you.
I can't work for you.
But just because it's Christmas Eve doesn't mean you won't like it.
Who are all these people?
People that need help.
So what do you do?
We help them.
We?
Oh, yes, I am sorry. Are you okay?
You know, I think the guy with my phone tried to ask me out.
Did you try to say yes?
Are you kidding? I don't know him.
Well, isn't that the point?
If I were you, I'd run.
Is there like a whole network of Secret Santas?
This is a great story. I mean, what better story can I write during Christmas time?
Nick is the most selfless person I have ever met, and he trusted me with a secret.
It's been said that if you help someone, you're the one that benefits the most.
You know, I'm still not sold on this whole I love Christmas aspect of my job, but I gotta admit, it's pretty cool.
Well, you're breathless too.
Oh, get over yourself.
App Envy. Watch BYU Sports Nation on BYU TV and BYU Radio apps.
I didn't think that would go public.
You!
My fault?
Your fault.
You're right, it's my fault. Maybe both of us?
Just the two of us.
Bryant left wing, Dastrup again. Again! Take Dastrup! Another three!
That's the exciting play of the game presented by Nissan, a proud partner of the BYU Cougars. Nissan, innovation that excites. Back on BYU Basketball with Dave Rose here in Studio C. It excited me. Peyton's second three on an eight-point night for him. We kind of broke it down a bit earlier, but he's got that shot in his arsenal for a big guy. That's a great weapon to have.
Yeah, and Eli read it really well because he came off that ball screen, and both the guys took Eli to try to stop him from, you know, penetrating, turning the corner, and they had a guy sitting down in, you know, in the key, and so Peyton popped instead of rolled. And we see Peyton make that shot all the time in practice. You know, he and so I don't think the bench was surprised. I don't think coaches were surprised. We'd worked on it all week. And, you know, for him to be able to come in and hit those two shots, and the one was really in a clutch situation when we hadn't scored for a few possessions. They were making him run at us. But I hope it just kind of ignites Peyton, because he's one of the greatest team guys that we've ever had, and he's got some real talent, and hopefully we can get him out on the floor and, you know, can help our team.
Right on. All right, time for some Coach Rose Q&A now, and Jeff Germain is in our studio at the mic with a question for Coach Rose. Hello, Jeff.
Happy birthday, Coach.
Thank you.
Hello, Greg. How much of the defensive... It's a soundtrack. How much of the defensive improvement do you attribute to running a slower, more deliberate offense, and how much is it defensive schematic changes?
Well, as far as our defense, you know, our execution, I don't think it has much to do with how we play offensively. I think some of the numbers might affect that. But defensively, it's a real commitment by our guys. And I think that, you know, it started in spring meetings right after the last season. But how are we going to, you know, correct, you know, some of the issues that we experienced this year and that we didn't really like? And it all came down, every guy, the same answer was, hey, we need to be a better defensive team. So that was a huge commitment by our guys. And then when we got here in the spring, I mean, in the summer, the first time we had all 15 guys here together, you know, for those 8 weeks in the summer. And bringing Coach Schroyer in was a real, you know, addition to that commitment. He's a guy that I've known for 20 some odd years. We coached together for 4 years, and that's really a real strength of his, is the defensive end. But we made a couple adjustments and scheme wise, but as far as how we're executing it, the guys are just really committed to it.
Jeff, thanks for your question. More Coach Rose Q&A is coming up after the break. This is BYU Basketball with Dave Rose here in Studio C. We're back in a minute.
On the basic level, we offer transportation. We carry four wheels, tailgates, and a place to rest your rump.
Beyond that, we provide adventures, opportunities, and jobs well done. So perhaps our favorite offering is our full line of trucks, including the new Nissan Titan. Right off I-15, Tim Daly Nissan Southtown and the popular full-size Nissan Titan. Think Nissan, think Tim Daly.
My first love is basketball. I want to play basketball as long as possible. I love the challenge.
Watch BYU take on Idaho State live this Thursday at 9 Eastern, 7 Mountain. We're all in to BYU TV Sports. A
summer. Don't be too conspicuous. There she is right there. My mind, yeah, it drags me back 5 years. I followed her.
Because they're walking in right now.
You guys are nice.
No, you're nice.
Joy to the world. The Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing.
BYU Basketball with Dave Rose is brought to you in part by Nissan, innovation that excites.
So we're seeing some of the Max Gift Christmas party pictures from last week for those watching with us on BYU TV. And Coach, it's always a special night in the year. Comes at the same time every year for you guys, and looked like it was another successful week for you.
Yeah, it's a great event, and you try to take it from a sad time in these families' lives to where we actually have a fun, happy time during the evening. Our players do a great job of interacting with them, and it's really quite heartwarming to watch our players kind of respond to that afterwards. I think it's a challenge to get 18 and 19 year old kids out of themselves, but in this setting, it's not a challenge at all because it happens pretty naturally.
Can you take another question right now?
Yeah.
All right, let's stay in studio. It's another member of the Germain family, Sal. Sal Germain, go ahead.
Happy birthday, Coach.
Thank you.
So my question is, the NBA is kind of moving to positionless rotations. Do you think college basketball will do the same?
Well, I think that it's turned into a game where, you know, the skilled, multifaceted player has become, you know, the thing that's really kind of drives the teams. A lot in college is four around one, where the four players, can all shoot it, pass it, drive it. Good free throw shooters, it can shoot to three, and then the one guy inside is now a guy who can step out on the perimeter. There's a lot of times in college where you see five guys out. We played three teams already this year who put all five guys out on a perimeter with no one inside and then just kind of drive to space. So I think that the NBA game is really kind of, transformed over into the college game.
Very astute question from Sal. Thank you. We're back with a very festive final segment of BYU Basketball with Dave Rose. Don't go away.
If I got hurt and was laid up at home, I wouldn't even think to call a lawyer. What a hassle. I'd want to meet them first.
What if I told you that for your first consultation, your lawyer will come to you, home or hospital?
Really?
Really.
They do that?
If you've been injured, we'll come to you. It's your job to get better. It's our job to deal with the insurance companies.
Learn more at SiegfriedandJensen.com.
A summer.
Don't be too conspicuous. There she is right there.
My mind, yeah, it drags me back 5 years. I follow her, wheeling through a week or more.
We don't even have time to practice. We you just have to run it because they're walking in right now.
You guys are nice.
No, you're nice.
You may not know this, but Studio C has a YouTube channel, so you should go subscribe and see sketches, behind-the-scenes footage, and lots of other fun stuff that I'm pretty sure you're going to want to be a part of. Think about it.
Find Studio C on YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. Connect with us, we'll connect with you.
Lou runs deep on BYU TV. Don't miss the BYU-Montana State women's basketball game, live Friday at 4 Eastern, 2 Mountain. Watch all of your favorite BYU teams on BYU TV, your home for Cougar sports.
I believe it's really important to be well-rounded. Being here at BYU is the best decision I ever made.
There's a time for everything. When it's time for basketball, locked in to play hoops.
My first love is basketball. I want to play basketball as long as possible. I love the challenge.
You're watching BYU TV. See the good in the world.
Welcome back to BYU Basketball with Dave Rose, presented by Siegfried and Jensen. That is our broadcast weekend and both games on BYU TV and BYU Radio. Radio coverage starts 1 hour before tip, TV right before at tip time. And so Idaho State Thursday and Texas Southern on Saturday, 8 o'clock Eastern both nights for radio pregame and a 9 o'clock Eastern time tip for radio and TV on both nights. Back on our final segment here of BYU Basketball with Dave Rose. Oh, look at this! Cosmo delivering some birthday cake for Coach Rose and everyone in tonight's audience. We are all going to enjoy that cake just moments from now. I'm told there's also ice cream on hand as well. Good stuff. Well, now in his 13th season as the head coach of the Cougars, and with 314 wins, Dave Rose has by far the best win percentage in BYU coaching history, and his career win rate ranks 8th nationally among active Division I coaches. He's on pace to, in a couple of seasons, become the winningest coach in Cougar hoops history, and today he turned 60. Here now, a 60-second collection of memories. We call it 60 for 60.
He's done a terrific job taking a team that was picked to finish last in the conference to a place where they're still in the race.
The sixth team in the country that won 2 games a week, particularly on the road in the back end. And even the Arizona fans get up and applaud Jimmer for
We congratulate Dave Rose, career win number 300 at BYU.
This is a good coat toss. I mean, if you're going to toss it and get the tee, you're going to slam it down just like that. That was some solid tossing that time by Coach Rose.
On the draw! Good one! By the Cougars for the third year in a row!
Six turnovers. It is done. BYU over Utah, 77-65.
All right, to the present day with Coach Rose, and maybe back in the day with, we have a really back in the day photo, like way, way back in the, like 60 years ago type photo. There's a...
It just keeps getting better. Yeah. Doesn't it? It just keeps getting better, better and better. You got any more pictures?
Now you can relax.
This can be like the... Like the Ellen DeGeneres show or the Oprah show. We're giving away cake. Everybody gets cake.
You get cake. Everybody, and you get you cake. And you get cake.
You get cake. We all get cake.
I hope you had a good night with us tonight.
It's awesome. Thanks, Greg.
All right, let's all go eat some cake and ice cream. We don't have a show next week. We've got a Christmas break next week. We're back with you on January 2nd. We'd love to see you here in Studio C. Again, to request your seats, go to BYUCougars.com/Rose Show. Do it on Monday or Tuesday of show week to reserve a spot in our audience. We'll talk to you on January 2nd, Tuesday, 8 Eastern, 6 Mountain for Yoli Childs and for Dave Rose, the birthday boy. I'm Greg Rubel. This has been BYU Basketball with Dave Rose, live from Studio C. So long.
160,000 miles. That's on average how often you'll use your car insurance. But what if you could get help with more often? And you could also save a couple of bucks on clothes or at restaurants. Skip the line at the DMV. Even get rescued roadside. You can when you're a member and your insurance is AAA. Insurance that's not